Communication. Models of communication. Many theorists have given some diagrammatic representations of communication process. We will discuss general model of communication. At the end of the session, you will be able to identify components of general model of communication. You will be able to illustrate general model of communication. Whenever we talk about communication process, we simplify it as message passing from sender to receiver and receiver giving feedback to the sender. This is very simple concept of communication which can be represented through simple model of communication. To understand general model of communication, we first need to understand very important term noise. Noise is anything received by the receiver other than the message. Even though sender intends a particular message, gives some form to the message and transmits the message or sends the message, there are some messages which are not intended by the sender but get mixed with the message. Now these noises may be external or internal. Some environmental factors which obstruct the process of communication, which get added into the message, are external noise elements. Sometimes characteristics of information source or characteristics of destination become obstacles and the nature of the message gets changed. These are internal noise factors. Keeping this interpretation of noise in mind, let us discuss general model of communication. Let's start with the simple model of communication. The simple model of communication says that the message passes from one person or one system to other person. So let's say that person or system A is the main information source who sends the message by encoding. This message travels through signal, and if we bring in mass communication model in the picture, transmitter channel and receiver channel are required to transmit the signals to person or system B, that is the destination, who is the end receiver of the message. This end receiver needs to decode the message because the message comes from encoder in a particular signal system. Changing this signal system is done by the receiver channel. Whenever we talk about so many channels and signals and messages, some noise is bound to appear. So we have to take care of minimizing this noise also, otherwise the entire nature of message gets changed. Once this message is decoded by the person at receiving it, he or she or the system interprets the message. After interpretation, feedback is encoded. Again, the feedback gets transmitted by the transmitter and received by the receiver. Because we are using a channel here also, noise gets added. This feedback message is decoded by person A or system A and interpreted there. So encoding, decoding continues. We require transmitter and receiver channel to pass on the signal, and noise element gets added in this entire process of communication, entire traveling of the message. In mass communication model, we see that the message only passes from one end to the other end and there is no feedback system. With the introduction of new technology, two-way communication is now possible. We are no more talking only about one-way traffic in mass communication, but we have attached feedback channel to it. For example, if you are transmitting your lecture to many places, you can receive their feedback, their queries, questions, comments through some other channels. For example, they can either call you They can send messages. They can even use social media such as WhatsApp or Hangout or any other tool to send you messages or to ask you queries. Because of this, general model of communication needs to be designed. This general model of communication is given by Dr. S.S. Kulkarni in his book. This general model of communication reveals some important facts about communication. In communication process, here we can see that sender and receiver both are active. It's no way now one-way process. Process of feedback is always initiated by the receiver in this model. The meaning of the message is not the one which is sent by the sender, but is ultimately what destination receives. And there is bound to be some difference in the nature of the message because of so many channels and the noise. Responsibility of decoding the message lies with the receiver because sender does not have immediate contact with the receiver. Channel is a link between the transmitter and receiver. Medium used for sending message and giving feedback may not be the same always. Receiver channel transforms the message in signal system, but that system should be known to the destination. Destination is the ultimate receiver of the message sent by the information source. Receiver is not the ultimate destination. Receiver only receives signals and converts in a suitable format for destination. It is not necessary that if there is no noise factor involved in sending message, feedback is also noiseless. So noise can appear either from sender to receiver or in the channel from receiver to sender. Now you can understand that impact of communication many a times depend on the channel capacity. If the channel has some problems, if the channel has noise, if the channel has limitations, communication gets affected. The classic example is bandwidth. Whenever we see that there is some problem in the bandwidth, signals are not properly received. Many a times videos don't get downloaded properly. Sometimes messages get distorted, pictures are blurred. So, channel capacity is very important in general model of communication.